Hello, Aluxers, and welcome back to what might be one of the most important Sunday motivational videos you've ever watched, because by the end of this piece, you'll understand how to keep more of your money than ever before. If you search for this kind of information on the web, you'll read about maxing out your contributions and so on, but that's not really what you're looking for, is it? Albert Einstein said it best, "The hardest thing in the world to understand is the income tax." The rich have very expensive accounting experts that help them minimize just how much money they pay in taxes. In the last decade, we've learned quite a lot about the field, and this experience has allowed our companies and personal wealth to grow at an accelerated rate. Write all of these down because you don't know when this information will come in handy. This isn't financial advice. This is just what we've seen the rich use to grow their wealth, and we believe it's valuable for you to know about it too. Welcome to Alux.com, the place where future billionaires come to get inspired. If you're not subscribed yet, you're missing out. Here are 15 ways rich people pay little to no taxes. Number 1. Invest all of it. The rich don't sit on cash unless they need it for something specific. Here's the golden rule when it comes to paying taxes. Reinvested profit is not taxed. If your company was about to make $5 million in profit and before the end of the fiscal year you choose to invest those $5 million back into the business in order to grow it even more, then you don't pay taxes on the $5 million. That's how companies grow quickly. As the owner of the business, your net worth goes through the roof with little to no tax to be paid. Number 2. Everything you use is owned by a business. The second golden rule of tax optimization is deduct everything. Here's the thing, if a business needs anything to function, the money you spend isn't taxable. You want to buy yourself a new car? Well, the company needs the car as well, so allow the company to buy it on the company's dime, and you still get to use it because you need it to run the business. Here are some things rich people deduct. Any type of technology, hardware, software, etc. Laptops, phones, gadgets, they're all needed for the business. Travel. Hotels and flights are needed for business trips. Home office and utilities, like the internet. Health insurance premiums. Even going out to eat is a deductible expense. The more things you can deduct, the less money there is to be taxed. Number 3. Move somewhere with little to no tax. People often underestimate just how big of an impact moving somewhere where they allowed you to keep your money would have on your life. This used to be the way it was back in the day. You would move to Dubai, Monaco, the Cayman Islands, or the Bahamas as your main residence. These countries have no income tax. They don't require you to pay any tax on the money you're making. But there is a catch. It's usually really expensive to move there, hence why the rich get an unfair advantage in life. The cost of living in Monaco is also incredibly high, but even with everything. Number 4. Send it overseas. This is how Facebook, Google, and Apple do it. They set up companies in Ireland because of its tax-friendly environment. These companies own the intellectual property. The US company needs to pay a licensing fee to the Ireland company every year to keep developing and selling products in the US. This created a legit deductible expense for the US company. Through this scheme, they're taking money out of the US economy and moving it to Ireland, where they end up paying only 1% or even less with even more optimization. If you live in a low-income tax country, you can always set up a local company there and invoice your US subsidiary for rendered services, minimizing the tax burden in the US. Companies like these tech giants would rather pay a fine than pay their taxes in full. The more you think about it, the more you realize a fine is a tax for doing something wrong. A tax is a fine for doing something right. Number 5. Charitable donations. The fifth rule of taxes, money donated to charity is not taxable. This is why every rich individual owns a foundation of some kind. But in their defense, the state is always proven to be a poor manager of money. So instead of giving the state all the money to do with it as it pleases, you're better off using a charitable foundation to make sure your money actually has a positive impact in your community. Where things get interesting is that even these non-taxable foundations have deductible expenses. They need things to function. You can even donate land, vehicles, or other assets to a charity that you own, and it still counts as a charitable contribution. Also, as the head of a charity group, you can still use the same car you donated on paper. Number 6. Instead of a salary, they take equity. As Queen Bee put it, pay me in equity. You do this for two reasons. One, equity might increase in value over time. And two, equity isn't taxable unless you sell it. This is how Elon Musk got so rich so quickly. Believe it or not, Elon's yearly salary is between $0 and $23,000. Yep, that's how many dollars Elon earns per year for his role as CEO of Tesla. Based on the company performance, Elon gets new minted stock instead. With Tesla being a public company, his net worth is skyrocketing, and at this rate, it's just a matter of time until he most likely becomes the richest man in the world. Number 7. Buying art. Here's something only the rich know. The art trade is the last major unregulated market. When you buy a piece of art, it counts as an expense, and if you've been following along by now, you should know that a good portion of expenses can be deductible. But as the rich know, there are layers to this. Let's say you earn $1 million this year and you decide to blow it on a $1 million painting. Since the expense matches the income, there's zero money left to be taxed. 3 years go by and now the same painting you own is worth $6 million, or at least that's what a professional appraiser says. Instead of selling it for profit, you decide to donate it to a museum, or better yet, to your art foundation. This means you just scored a $6 million tax deductible. Assuming you're still earning $1 million a year, you just saved an additional $5 million in non-taxable income, and that's all legal. You could even go for another round if you wanted to. Let's say you decide to sell the painting at $6 million valuation, earning you $5 million in profit on that deal, which normally would be taxed, right? But the government once again comes to the aid of the super wealthy. If you take all the money you made from the sale, all $6 million, and buy more art with it, you don't have to pay any taxes on the profit you've made from the sale. That's why rich people buy art, and this is the kind of information people subscribe to our channel for. You're not getting this anywhere else. Number 8. Multiple nationalities with no fixed residence. This is probably the shadiest and most confusing one on the list, but people have done this successfully everywhere around the world. When it comes to paying taxes, you must pay taxes in your country of residence, your home country. But what happens when you no longer have a home country? There are plenty of super wealthy individuals that choose not to have a home country, despite owning properties all over the world. When institutions ask for a proof of address, they provide one from a property they own in Thailand or Bhutan that's in a different language and overlooked by a government that has no intention of providing any additional information. Then there are folks who buy a massive yacht and use that as their primary home. One day you're moored off the coast of Monaco, the next you're in international waters. Even though we recommend having more than one nationality so you can reap the benefits of multiple passports, we don't think that going full off the grid is a good long-term solution. Number 9. Gift money away. Did you know you can gift things to people and the gift is non-taxable? Crazy, right? There is a $15,000 cap on the gift, though. If the gift is worth less than the $15,000, you don't have to tell the IRS about it as it counts as a non-taxable event. You might think, cool, but is this a video about really rich people and how they optimize to make the most of it? $15,000 barely gets you into the Rolex game gift-wise. And you're kinda right, $15,000 might not sound like a lot, but there's more room to maneuver. As of 2021, the lifetime gift exemption is capped at $11.7 million in the US as long as each gift is less than $15,000. $11.7 million in tax-free wealth translates to a damn lot of Rolex watches. Number 10. Hold it in privacy coins. Crypto is changing the game in terms of wealth transfers and wealth security. The fact that you can put $1 billion onto a stick, put it in your pocket, and fly to Singapore with it is mind-blowing. With the likes of Bitcoin and Ethereum, which are heavily regulated, measures are in place to provide transparency, link wallets to individuals, and make sure everyone is paying their fair share. By the way, profits from the sale of crypto are only taxed at 10% in most countries, still giving a better return than some other assets if you take into account the industry price appreciation. If all this sounds super exciting to you, go to alox.com/Bitcoin and look over our Bitcoin Essentials course. It's meant to help you get started with crypto as quickly as possible. And if you use the code ALOXER, you can get 25% off at checkout. Bitcoin is completely legal and it's here to stay, but there's more to it. The rise of blockchain has given way to a new breed of technological currencies called privacy coins. These can be exchanged, stored, and transferred completely anonymously. Privacy coins aren't illegal, but their legality remains subject to each jurisdiction. The most popular ones are Monero, Dash, and Zcash. The belief is that once you make your money legally, you should be allowed to spend it without other parties overlooking your transactions. Number 11. You have no money, but you have assets you can borrow against. Here's why most rich people are super wealthy, but cash poor. In order to take cash out of your business, you need to pay taxes on that money. So rich people choose to never take their money out, just leave it as stocks and assets. But there are situations where you need some kind of cash. That's where the relationship you have with your bank comes into play. Rich people walk into banks and say, "Look how much stuff I own, the cars, the assets, the stocks. I'm good for the money if it comes to it, so give me a loan." The bank looks at their portfolio and give wealthy individuals access to quick cash anytime they want. Since this is technically a loan they take, this isn't their money, so they're not required to pay tax just to give it back. If all of that happens through a company and not from an individual perspective, this mutually beneficial relationship can go on for generations. Number 12. Filing for bankruptcy. Filing for bankruptcy is expensive, tiresome, and complicated, unless you're super rich and know how to get over it. Here's how the process works. Let's say you're a pretty decent lawyer making $250,000 a year. You own a $1 million house and manage to save an additional $1 million. You're looking to go into business, so you decide to buy a $10 million office building because it'll make you a lot of money. You go to a bank, put your $1 million down and get a $9 million loan and buy the office building. 1 year later, a pandemic hits and all of your tenants leave. You still owe the bank $9 million. To make matters worse, the building you bought is now worth only $5 million because nobody wants to buy an office building. Since the office building is owned through a company, our lawyer can now file for bankruptcy. Although they will take the office building away from him and he will have a really hard time ever working with the bank again, bankruptcy laws prevent the bank from taking away the house or siphoning off his wages. There's this difference between being poor and being broke. Rich people can be broke, meaning that on paper their net worth might be zero or even negative, but they'll never be poor. Also, if you don't need the bank, pay it all out in cash. The financial loss would still count as tax deductible, meaning that for the many years to come, you won't need to pay taxes on your income until you catch up to the amount of money you lost. Number 13. Claim your yacht as your second home. Here's an interesting observation when it comes to taxes. Governments love homeowners, and despite the super wealthy who like to splurge, they really want to tax these show-offs. Hashtag tax the rich. It's actually trending all around the internet right now. So what do rich people do to combat this? They claim their yacht as a secondary home to get better taxation rates. At the end of the day, it is true. They're using it as a holiday home when they're traveling to Mykonos during the summer. As long as the boat has sleeping, cooking, and toilet facilities, then the IRS treats the boat as a second home. Motorhomes can also be used in the same way, but how many super rich people are buying motorhomes these days? Number 14. Using a trust to avoid paying estate tax. Among the rich, there is a funny saying that goes like this. A person doesn't know how much he has to be thankful for until he has to pay taxes on it. Unless you're rich, you might not be aware of this. If you're rich and you die, the state taxes up to 45% of the wealth you want to pass on to your children. It's called an estate tax. By the way, here's an important piece of information. The U.S. qualifies you as rich if you're worth more than $11.7 million. For everyone worth less than that, there isn't an estate tax, or it's considerably lower. $11.7 million might sound like a lot of money to the average person, but we're living in the realms of billionaires, and we're likely going to have our first trillionaire in this lifetime. With inflation the way it's going right now, everyone will be a millionaire eventually. The way rich people are structuring their wealth in order to keep the state from taxing it away is by using trusts. If you put things into a trust, then provided certain conditions are met, they no longer belong to you, so it's not really yours to pass on to your children. Once the property is held in trust, it's outside of anyone's estate for inheritance tax purposes. It also protects you from putting all of your wealth under the name of your child, because they could easily blow through it if they decided to, so the control remains with you while you're alive. You can also set up smart contract-like rules, where your children get gradual access to the assets in the trust under certain conditions, like when they turn 25 or graduate post-secondary. Number 15. Depreciating assets on paper to outweigh the cash income. Accounting is the language of money, so if you want to be rich, you better learn how to speak it or at least understand it. In simple terms, depreciation is a deduction that enables a business to write off the cost of the investment it buys, be it a car, a machine, so on. It's spread out for the life of the investment. The reason behind spreading deductions for a cost of property is to enable a business to be in a position to replace the property at the end of its life. Now, let's say you buy a factory for $10 million and intend to use it to make those ugly-looking face shields for the next 10 years. From an accounting perspective, every year the value of that factory will be depreciating by $1 million. If you make less than $1 million per year from selling your face shields, there's no profit left to tax. Equipment, vehicles, and even offices can be depreciated from an accounting perspective, allowing you to keep paying less and less tax. If people knew how to optimize their money, their businesses would grow at much faster rates, allowing them to hire more people and create better products. You are under no obligation to pay more taxes than is legally required. Taxation was meant to help the poor, but since everything is privatized and optimized for profit, it doesn't work the way it was intended. We have a large audience from everywhere around the world, so we're curious to know, what percent do you pay in taxes in your country? Let us know in the comments. It'll for sure make for an interesting conversation. And as for those of you who on a Sunday dedicated some time to watch a video on taxes until the very end, of course, there's a bonus waiting. Taxes are high because of inefficiencies. In reality, everyone wants to pay their fair share. The problem arises in the management of those taxes and the variation of terms on how much one should pay. You don't want to pay your taxes when your government doesn't use it to benefit you. This is one of the reasons why the people of Switzerland are actually fine with the high level of taxes they pay, because the government does with the contribution what a government should do. Education is free and qualitative. Hospitals are free, state-of-the-art, and good. The environment is clean and blossoming, and the overall population is quite happy. Compare that with the way corrupt governments choose to spend your money. The bribes, the roads, the corrupt system, it all breaks your spirit because it feels like you're being played. And you kinda are. It's 2021. We have mind-blowing technology available to us. Why can't we choose where our money goes through an app on our screen? Of course, there needs to be a portion that goes to the military and security and healthcare, but where does the bulk of it go? Why can't you choose to deploy your own resources to the school in your neighborhood or fix the roads in your city? This is why we believe blockchain will have a massive impact on society. It removes the need of middlemen to make decisions on your behalf. There can be a smart contract written where a small percentage of your income gets automatically attributed to the causes you care about with full transparency and control. How much is your government wasting? How many people are employed only to push papers from one office to another? We can't wait for it to be all automated. We need leaders and transparent technology more than we need politicians, and governments are up for disruption. The way we pay our taxes will change this decade, and we can't wait for the system to be fully optimized. Hopefully you, the Aluxer, will benefit from this upgrade. If you've made it to this point and are ready for governments to be disrupted, please write the word upgrade in the comments. The world is yours, Aluxer. Go get it.